This geometric pattern is mesmerizing, and the techniques to make it are both interesting and useful to know. So let's make this vector together in today's tutorial. Every portfolio website needs a good domain name, and that is super simple to do with Hover. Learn more about this first class service and how to showcase your work through a new portfolio site later in today's video, but also how you can grab 10% off your first purchase with Hover. So I do have a nice beige kind of color for my background, and I did simply make that with the rectangle tool, and I locked it down with Command or Control 2, and most of you guys probably know this kind of stuff anyway. But for the pattern, we do want a nice dark color, and we only want the stroke selected in the color palette. And you can of course toggle this with Command or Control X, as seen here. So press M for the rectangle tool, and whilst holding down Shift, click and drag to make a perfect square on your artboard. So the thickness of your square is entirely up to you guys, and we can change that later, so it's not really crucial at this stage the thickness that you use. We want to open up the appearance panel because we are going to make some great use of the vector superpowers found in this panel. So firstly, we want to duplicate this stroke in the fly down menu. That's going to leave us with two strokes the same size, but click that new stroke and then offset the path found here. So make sure you have the preview box checked and also type in the value that best fits your design. We're going to repeat this process two more times. So do click the new stroke, duplicate it, and offset the path exactly the same as we did before. We do want to end up with four different strokes equally distanced apart. So when you've arrived at this stage, you should have four squares that effectively are on one vector path. But now it's time to expand the appearance of this design, and then also ungroup everything. This is going to leave you with four vector paths independent of each other. And so for the next step, press C, which is going to access the scissors tool, and then click the top left anchor point of the smallest square. So once that's been completed, press A for the direct selection tool and carefully click the anchor point whilst holding down a click and move it outward. And you should be able to see the smart guides showing you when things are snapping in a fixed position. Or you can just hold down Shift, which will make sure the line stays level as you outstretch it towards the left. So yeah, move it to the very end square and it should snap directly onto the path perfectly. We're going to want to repeat this process two more times and also clean up the remaining lines in this top section. Okay, so the top section is complete. Now do the exact same for the bottom right section, and I am actually going to skip ahead today so you don't have to watch the same process again. So we've arrived at this shape here, and I do have some neat and handy tips to show you, so let's finish off this geometric design. So one thing that you will for sure want to keep in mind relates to the strokes that your design is made up of. You can see here that my design has a stroke value of 7, but if I select my design and then scale it down by clicking and dragging whilst holding down Shift, my design stays at a value of 7 in terms of the stroke, but the design looks very different, and actually it does look pretty cool. However, if you want to be able to change the size of your design but keep the appearance same and also relative, you will need to activate the scale stroke options in the preferences settings. So I would now suggest that you set the stroke value to whatever you think looks best for your design. So maybe you want some thick strokes and thin gaps, or something different, it's entirely up to you. But when you are ready, select the entire design and hold down the Alt Option key, and your cursor should change as you can see here. Whilst still holding down the Alt Option key, click upward. If you also hold down Shift at this moment, your design is going to remain in line perfectly as you drag it up. But yeah, drag it up until you see the smart guides letting you know things are perfectly in line. And by the way, smart guides can be turned on or off with Command and Control U. So with the duplication at the very top, select it, hold down shift and also rotate it 90 degrees in this way. Great, we now need to select everything and then duplicate it over to the right using the Alt Option key one more time. With the new selection still highlighted, hold down shift again and rotate things 180 degrees this time. Make sure to release your mouse click before you release any keyboard shortcuts. You can still alter the stroke weight value if you don't think it looks right for your design. But now we have a sort of geometric square. But select the square and then duplicate it exactly over to the right once, then directly after, press Command or Control D multiple different times. So essentially repeat the process of duplicating and arranging your design as you see fit. I personally like to hold down shift and rotate the design 45 degrees after it's finished because I think that orientation looks best. So when you're happy with your design on the artboard, grab the rectangle tool with M and then carefully drag a rectangle around the perimeter of your box. Then select everything excluding your background because that should be locked anyway, and then right click so you can access the clipping mask. This just neatens things up a little bit, but you can also experiment with the transparency modes, as this will kind of blend your design into the background. So as you should be able to see by now, setting up a personal presence online to promote your skills is pretty essential. And a service that can really help with that is Hover. Now Hover is a great place to find and grab your domain name, with over 400 domain extensions available to you. So maybe you cannot afford the .com version of your domain name, you will still have many, many other options available to you. Hover also offers totally free Whois privacy, and you can create personalized email addresses that match your domain. And this is one key aspect to appearing professional online. So as an example, my email address could be tom@satorigraphics.net, as opposed to satorigraphics@hotmail.com. It just looks more professional. Hover also has a superb customer support team where they're open to either having a talk, a chat, an email, or even sharing a tweet about your problem. There is also a Hover Connect feature that allows you to connect your domain name to website builders if you are, of course, using a website builder. Now, if you want to grab 10% off your first purchase with Hover, follow the link down in the description box below. If you guys want to learn something else today, do click a video on screen. But until next time, design your future today. Peace.